Hello friends, welcome to Tech Study Cell. In this video, we will make an Alexa home automation system which also can be controlled with Bluetooth, IR remote and manual switches. Here you can see I have not used any external Bluetooth device and you don't need any third-party IoT application. You just need an Echo Dot and ESP32 to make this complete project. So this project is absolutely free, and during the video I have explained the circuit, source code and all other required details. So after watching the complete video, you can easily make this project. First, let me control the appliances with Amazon Alexa app.
Alexa,
turn on room light.
Okay.
Now let me control the appliances with Bluetooth, and I can use this button to turn off all the lights. Now let me use the IR remote to turn on all the lights, and I can also control the appliances individually. Now let me use manual switch to control the appliances. And if there is no Wi-Fi, still you can control the appliances with Bluetooth, IR remote, and also with the manual switches. Now let me turn on the fast two lamp. Now if I turn off the complete supply, here you can see ESP32 do not have any power supply right now. Now if I turn on the supply again, the fast two lamp will automatically turn on as the ESP32 can remember the previous states as we have used preference library. And here you can see the fast two lamp automatically turns on. So this is a very useful project. So without any further delay, let's get started. This video is sponsored by Altium, which is a world-class PCB designer software trusted by the most of the big electronic companies. The user interface is so simple, you can easily design any complex PCBs in Altium. Now Altium came up with an amazing product called Altium 365. Altium 365 is an electronic product design platform that unites PCB design, MCAD, data management and teamwork. With Altium 365, you can not only design PCBs, but you can also share your projects to your teammates for review. It also provides automatic backup, centralized cloud storage and a lot more. And along with all this, they do have a very useful search engine just for electronic components called as Octopart. Using Octopart, you can search for any electronic components, compare the price and availability around the globe. Apart from that, you can also check the datasheet. Altium provides everything to make your production task a lot easier. And now you can download the free trial version of the Altium PCB Designer software from the description and use all these services in your next PCB design. In the circuit, I have given the 5V DC supply, and here I have used active low relay module. So the relay will turn on for the low signal in the control pin. If you want to use 8-channel relay module, then you can refer to this circuit. To make the circuit compact, I have designed these PCBs for this project. You can download the GABA file from the video description. Now let me connect the ESP32 with the laptop for programming. This is the source code for this project. You can download the code from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article. You can find the link in the description. Then you can download the code from these buttons. After downloading, open the code with Arduino IDE. For this project, first you have to install the latest ESP32 board, and these are the required libraries for this project. Then here you have to enter the Wi-Fi name, then Wi-Fi password. Here you have to enter the device names for Alexa. Alexa will identify that particular device with this name. You can change these names as per your requirements. Then here you have to enter the hex code for the IR remote control. In my previous video, I have already explained how to get the hex code from any IR remote. You can find the link in the description, also in the I button. And if you don't want to use IR remote control, then leave it as it is. Then here I have mentioned the GPIO pins for the relay and switches. Now let me go to void setup. In the void setup, first I have defined a baud rate. Then with this line, I have opened the namespace in read-write mode to store the current relay state. Then with this function, we are turning on the Bluetooth. Then we are giving the name for the Bluetooth. You can give any other name. Now let me go to void loop. In the void loop,
First, we are checking if the Wi-Fi is connected, then accordingly we are controlling the relay with Alexa. Now let me go to this Bluetooth control function. With this function, we are controlling the relay with Bluetooth. Now in the Bluetooth control function, first we are checking if any data available from the Bluetooth. Then we are comparing that data with the predefined value. If we receive capital A, then we are turning on the fast relay. If we receive small a, then we are turning off the fast relay. In this manner, we are controlling the four relay. Now you can also use any other Bluetooth app. You just have to change this character according to that app. Now after doing all these changes, you can upload this code to ESP32. For that, go to Tools. Select the board ESP32 dev module. In the partition scheme, select huge app 3MB. This is important. You have to select this partition scheme only. Then select the proper port. Then hit the upload button. After programming the ESP32, you can see this blue LED is glowing, which indicates now it is connected with the Wi-Fi. So now we will configure the Amazon Alexa app. So let me open the Amazon Alexa app. Then I will go to device. Then tap on this plus icon, select add device. Then select light. Then I will scroll down and select other. Now I will select Wi-Fi, then select discover devices. Now during this time, the Echo Dot, Amazon Alexa app and the ESP32 should be connected with the same Wi-Fi network. This will take some time. Now here you can see 4 devices found. So I will tap on next. So these are the devices. Now I will exit from this setup. Then I will go to device, then go to lights. Now here you can see all the devices we have connected. Now we will quickly install the Bluetooth app for this project. I have made this app in the MIT App Inventor. You can download the APK file from the video description. After downloading, go to My Files, then select APK. So we have to install this app. Let me tap on it, then tap on Install. During installing, you may get some warning as I have not submitted this app in the Google Play Store. Now let me open the app. So with this app, you can control total 8 relay, but here we will control 4 relay using first 4 buttons. So after installing, you have to give nearby device permission to this app so that it can search nearby Bluetooth device. So I will go to setting, then I will go to apps, then app management. From this list, I have to search for Bluetooth switch app. Now go to permission. Now here you have to give nearby device permission so that it can search nearby Bluetooth device. Now I will turn on the Bluetooth. First I have to pair the ESP32. So here you can see under the available device, it is showing ESP32_BT, which is the Bluetooth name we have given. I will tap on it, then tap on pair. After pairing, I will go to our app. Then if I tap on this tap to connect button, so here you can see our Bluetooth device ESP32_BT. I will tap on it. So here you can see it is showing connected. So now we can control the appliances with Bluetooth. Now I can control the appliances with the Bluetooth, Amazon Alexa app, also with the switch and IR remote. If you find this video helpful, then please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.